हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द क्लास ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ कॉमर्स एंड मैनेजमेंट चैप्टर 5 पार्ट 1 स्टाफिंग. चिल्ड्रन, वी हैव लर्नड अबाउट स्टाफिंग इन सेकेंड चैप्टर. इट इज़ एन इम्पॉर्टेंट मैनेजरियल फंक्शन लाइक अदर फंक्शंस ऑफ मैनेजमेंट. स्टाफिंग इज़ अ प्रोसेस ऑफ फिलिंग पोजिशंस और पोस्ट इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विद एडिक्वेट एंड क्वालिफाइड पर्सनल. Staffing is the process of acquiring, deploying and retaining a workforce of sufficient quantity and quality to create positive impacts on the organization's effectiveness. So children, in organization we decided how many employees we want, and now staffing is a process in which we appoint the number required. So in ordinary sense, the term staffing is merely recruitment. It includes acquiring, training and maintaining the employees, but in wider sense it is scientific recruitment, their selection, training, promotion, transfer and post-retirement activities are included. Planning of business might have been done in the best possible manner and the formation of organization also might have been proper, but if selection and training of the personnel is improper, then the organization cannot be successful. Children, the success of the organization totally depends upon the efficiency, attitude, loyalty of the employees. So it is the job or the duty of the organization and the management to keep the staff contented and satisfied. Jitne hi wo log motivated rahenge kaam karne ke liye, मन से हमारे ऑफिस में प्रमाइसिस में काम करेंगे, दे विल वर्क बेटर एंड दिस विल रिड्यूस द लेबर टर्न ओवर रेट. सो स्टाफिंग इज एन एक्टिविटी ऑफ मेंटेनिंग रिलेशन विद द एम्प्लॉयज ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. नाउ चिल्ड्रन, लेट अस बिगिन विद द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ स्टाफिंग. फर्स्ट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फंक्शन ऑफ मैनेजमेंट. Staffing is one of the important function of management like other functions: planning, organizing, directing, controlling and coordinating. Next is perennial process. Organization cannot exist without employees. Perennial means continuous. As long as the organization activities exist, employees and staffing will also exist. Next, concerned with human relations. The main objective of staffing is to acquire the right employees and make the best use of them. Employees, children, are the only living factor, the only M which is living, of production. They have feelings and self-respect. As it is related with human element, humanitarian behavior is expected towards them. Next is, staffing is a dynamic process. Children, because of proper staffing, all the activities of the organization become dynamic. Next, related with other managerial functions. Other managerial functions we learnt in the second chapter, that is planning, organizing, directing, coordinating and controlling, are closely related with this function of staffing. Next, wide scope. Staffing is not merely an activity for labor welfare but is also concerned with acquiring, training and maintaining the personnel as it works for their development. So its scope is wide. Lastly, it is a capital expenditure or an investment for the business. The expenditure incurred, children, for the recruitment, selection, training and development of the staff is not an expense of the business, but it is such an investment of the business which is not shown in company's balance sheet, because we invest it thinking in mind for a longer duration of time. We consider our business employees as an asset of the business. That is why this expense is considered as an investment. Now let us start with the new topic, that is importance of staffing function. Staffing occupies an important place in process of management. Any organization without staff, children, is like a skeleton. The inanimate machines can increase production, but employees can give even better results. मशीन सिर्फ प्रोडक्शन कर सकती है बट रिजल्ट बेस्ट थिंग विथ फीलिंग्स कैन बी डन बाय द एम्प्लॉयज दैट इज व्हाई एन एक्सपर्ट हैज राइटली सेड माइंड योर मैन मैन विल माइंड एवरीथिंग फॉर यू दैट इज वी हैव टू टेक गुड केयर ऑफ आवर एम्प्लॉयज एंड द रेस्ट ऑल वर्क्स विल बी टेकन केयर बाय आवर एम्प्लॉयज हम अपने एम्प्लॉयज़ का ध्यान रखें बाकी बिजनेस का सारा ध्यान हमारे एम्प्लॉयज़ अगर सेटिस्फाइड हैं तो वो हमारे बिजनेस का बढ़िया ध्यान रखेंगे नाउ लेट अस बिगिन द फर्स्ट पॉइंट इज ड्राइविंग फोर्स कंटेंडेड दैट इज सेटिस्फाइड एंड एफिशिएंट स्टाफ इज द ड्राइविंग फोर्स विच कीप्स द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन रनिंग Next, it is a dynamic activity. Staffing infuses dynamism into business and performs all activities of the business. Important for other functions of management. Other managerial functions like coordinating, directing, controlling, planning cannot succeed if we do not have proper staff at work. Limbs of the business enterprise. Planning occupies the place of the brain. Children, we have learned that in human body, planning is the brain, organization is the structure, while staffing is said to be the limbs. Without limbs, we cannot do work. Same way, business cannot work without the proper staff. Without staff, activities cannot be done in an organization. Coming on to the next is job satisfaction among employees. Due to staffing, the complaints and problems of employees can be understood and speedy solution is possible. Proper planning and distribution of work creates children feeling of job satisfaction among the employees, which motivates them to work better. Next, harmony in relations. Staffing creates an environment of satisfaction among employees. It helps to establish good cordial relationship between the employers and employees, due to which productivity increases and finally the profitability of the business increases. Increase in the prestige of the organization. A satisfied and efficient staff is said to be an invaluable asset of the business. It increases the prestige of the organization. Lastly, children, it is a continuous process. The very existence of business is not possible without staff. We cannot think of any business without staff. As long as business continues, we require staff. And staffing process will continue. That is why it is said that staff is the limbs of the business and it is considered as an invaluable asset of the business. Now let us begin with the new topic. Staffing is a part of HRM. Nowadays, children, staffing department is considered as separate human resource department, HRD. Human resource management is the process of planning for recruiting necessary staff and developing it for the achievement of enterprise objectives. This HRM, that is human resource management, right from appointment, selection, training of the workers, all works till post-retirement activities is being done by this separate department, that is HRM. Earlier, this work was done by the organization itself, but now, as we learned in the meaning that we go for scientific recruitment of the staff. So, whole work is done by separate department. Generally, staffing includes recruitment, selection and training. It also includes materialistic facilities, progressive wage system, employees' welfare, while HRM includes growth and development of personnel. In these days of global competition, the importance of human resource has increased because it is necessary to preserve our invaluable assets and motivate them, give them progressive wages so that they remain intact in our organization and labor turnover rate decreases. And this is the work which this separate department of HRM do. Now let us start with process of HRM. Concerned with manpower planning. The first point is to plan for required staff in the organization and increase the staff through new appointments. As I told you earlier, children, the work of this department is to first know from various departments that which and what type of staff is required and accordingly do the placement of the same. As per need, necessary and selective reduction in the staff. If we have more staff, so we should not waste unnecessary money on the salary of their staff, and proper reduction of staff is done. Appropriate placement of the staff. To keep the staff constantly active and enhance their knowledge, it is the duty of the HRD to constantly keep them updated with the upcoming new techniques and enhance the knowledge as per the need of the respective department. जहाँ जिस तरह की training की ज़रूरत है, सारे employees को, irrespective of the level of management, they are being given necessary trainings. Process of HRM is divided into two parts. The first was concerned with manpower planning, while the second part is concerned with compensation and development of the staff. This includes to provide work-related training to the staff. As per their work, each and every staff should be provided necessary training to provide conducive environment to the staff and also opportunities to improve their proficiency in their particular respective work, to give proper compensation and benefits to the staff. Whatever medical benefits, other compensations are to be provided, they should be given to them as per their respective post. To recognize work-related problems, find solutions for the same and implement them. Whatever problems our staff is facing in the working premises, to know them, to understand them, and to find necessary solutions. According to HRM, employees are not merely factors of production, but they are more than that. Children, they are not only the factors of production. We learn earlier also that without the staffing or staff, our organization will be mere a skeleton. Management principles and functions are adopted to create a stable staff. This reduces the rate of labor turnover and increases the efficiency and job satisfaction of employees, by which organizational objectives and employee objectives can be achieved. Children, we learned in this video the meaning of staffing, characteristics, importance, and staffing is considered.
जलने वालों की तो रूह भी जलानी है, एक कहानी है जो सबको सुनानी है, इनकी भूख भी तो मैंने ही मिटानी है, इनको क्या पता मैंने करी कितनी मेहनत, सारी बातों से था मैं पूरा सहमत, सारी जिंदगी इन्होंने मुझको रुलाया, इनको भी तो मिला था जो मैंने कमाया, रोते रोते भी इनका